Yes, well, I'm sorry. It's not like I'm nominated for a CB every year. Oh, wait a minute. Yes, it is. Well, as some illustrious person once said, popularity is the hallmark of mediocrity.
You just made that up, didn't you?
Yes, but I stand by it.
Well, if you ask me, it's probably nothing, but there are some weirdos out there, so just keep your eyes open.
Oh, dear, she's not a weirdo. She's just a woman who finds me utterly fascinating.
And the distinction would be...
Who is it, please?
Lizzie Borden, I want you to autograph my hatchet.
Or else your admirer ran into him first, and he's stuffed in some janitor's closet, his purple, bloated tongue protruding above his freshly garroted neck. Is that champagne?
Oh, you're a fountain of comfort this evening.
Oh, I...
Make a little hole in the ice with this little corkscrew thingy and then just start fishing?
It's called an auger.
Well, imagine my embarrassment.
Here's your hot buns, Dan.
Oh, thanks. What am I gonna sit on?
The auger's free.
Oh, dear, don't turn around. It's that dreadful woman who works for you.
Who?
Lady Macbeth without the sincerity.
Hello, I'm Niles, a person at the table.
Niles, thank God you're here. Back me up. Give him some sound brotherly advice.
She's the devil, Fraser. Run fast, run far.
Good morning, Niles. What a lovely surprise. We were just about to sit down to a big family breakfast. Won't you join us?
Come on in, Niles. It's all right. We were celebrating. You see, the station called to renegotiate my contract.
Oh. Paid your commission up front, I see. I'm just glad you're all right. I would have assumed she killed after mating.
Well, let's face it. Once a woman has dipped her toe into Crane Lake, dry land is never the same again.
Yes, she's probably home in her room writing Mrs. B.B. Crane over and over in the margin of her algebra book.
Just enough time to show you the John Steinbeck first edition I bought at the rare book fair, St. Katie the Virgin, in like new condition.
Yes, well, she'd have to be, wouldn't she?
Quite a charming book, really. It's a shame more people haven't read it.
Oh, let's see.
Don't touch. The smallest smudge decreases its value.
Oh, Niles, guess what? Thriving Seattle night spot is closing its doors.
Roz, you're moving. To a patient of mine today, Caroline. As a result of your fast food approach to psychiatry, she left me.
Caroline was your patient?
2 years of my hard work wiped out by one of your 2-minute McSessions.
I merely suggested that she consider a change.
Based on what diagnostic method? One potato, two potato?
I was in college. I was trying to find myself.
All you needed to do was look under the nearest man.
Yeah, sorry, Bulldog.
Me too. I'll call Francois, see if he can get us a table on the patio.
If you don't come out in the next 3 seconds, I'm going to reach in there and drag you out by your ankles.
Hello, Roz. Playing hard to get?
It's Bulldog. You're a psychiatrist. Help him.
As distressed as I am by his condition, he's not the only one suffering here. In 8 minutes, Fraser and I are going to lose our patio table.
Well, as long as Fraser's filling in for Bulldog, you're not going anywhere.
You poor man, help is at hand.
No, no shrinks. I hate shrinks. They're all a bunch of wimps, weirdos. Help me.
There, there. I'm here for you. And you're over there for me. I sense you're in a great deal of pain.
Yeah? Make it stop.
No. No, the first step toward healing is not to bury the pain, but to feel it at its fullest depth. Okay, well, before security arrives, let's skip on to step two.
What is going on?
Excuse me, Bulldog. Fraser, please, we're in session.
Look, Knox, we have to pull this man together in minutes, not in a lifetime, for God's sake.
How dare you talk to me like that? You
think I will talk to you anyway. I wish to. Oh, wait, we don't have the time for this now. Get out.
All right. Bulldog, I'm referring you to my brother. Fraser, I'll call Francois, tell him there's been a death in the family. That ought to buy us another 10 minutes.
But tomorrow you're gonna find somebody even hotter. And you know what you're gonna do?
Nah.
You're gonna have your fun with her, and then you're gonna dump her just for the hell of it. Yeah. Dump her! And you know what? You're not gonna feel bad about it at all. You know why? Because we're guys, and that's what guys do.
Distressing news, Fraser. Francois gave away our table.
Screw him!
Excuse me?
You heard what I said. We don't need him or his stinky little restaurant. There are plenty of restaurants in town. I say we go somewhere we don't even need a reservation.
Thank you, Nance.
You're welcome.
Yes, you know, if we hasten, perhaps we can catch the first idiot, Le Cigar Volant.
Just a bit distracted today. You see, this morning, a man from my building approached me with a very intriguing problem. Seems he's been having a recurring dream.
Oh, please, that little gambit didn't work when we were in knee socks. What was your dream, Fraser?
Oh, all right. The shower turns off, and out from the bathroom steps a man. All right, go ahead, let me have it.
Are you saying that now, or is that a quote from the dream?
Please.
In this dream of yours, were there any cigars, bananas, or short blunt swords?
Would you stop it? 43. A little late for latency.
She is okay over here?
We're fine.
Well, you must be new here. I'm sure I would have remembered such a pretty face as yours.
You're overcompensating.
Right. We're fine. Bye-bye. Crescent. Croissant. Butter. Apricot jam. Hunger.
Food.
Diet. My God, I've been on a diet. Do you think that's useful?
You could stand to lose a few pounds.
These guys think I have bad taste in clothes.
Well, I like the way you dress.
I believe that's what's called the clincher. Shall we go?
My God, it is T.H. Eliot. We're a stone's throw away from one of the giants of American literature.
Not the way you throw.
Oh, now, this is incredible. My God, the man's entire life is shrouded in mystery. Yeah, there he is.
I've always idolized him. What I wouldn't give to meet that man.
Well, why don't you go up and introduce yourself?
Oh, I can't just walk up to a god like that.
Well, then find a subtler way.
In your vernacular, that would be what? To slingshot your panties across the street?
Well, he must still be out on the street. Let's go.
I'm parking it here. They got the Mariners game on.
Dad, please, we can't waste time.
Oh, let him be. He's dead weight.
Right.
If I had published that book, my reputation would have been destroyed. At least... now I'm left with a shred of dignity.
Just think, hundreds of radio psychiatrists, all in the same location. One well-timed avalanche and the dignity of the entire psychiatric profession could be restored.
Yeah, good one. We always count on you for some witty retort.
I insult you and you compliment me. Could the request for a favor be far behind?
Damn! You are perceptive.
Oh, stop it. Me standing in for you? I'm sorry, Fraser. I couldn't presume to fill those big floppy red shoes of yours.
But please, please, Niles. Look, I'm begging you. There's another station wants to replace me with Helen Grogan, better known as Ma Nature. She does a gardening show, and I'm just a little worried that a week of discussing well-rotted manure will weaken my listener base.
It hasn't yet.
Hey, Dr. Doolittle. I heard your show. It didn't suck.
Dear diary.
So how's it feel?
Like I'm walking away from my lamppost and counting the bills in my garter belt.
Why does Lilith have to tag along anyway?
Well, she just didn't want to spend the holiday alone. Her husband is off in New Zealand exploring a volcano.
Why couldn't she go with him?
Well, because if she accidentally fell in, the shockwave from the hottest thing in nature meeting the coldest would actually crack the earth in two.
As if a smile from Maris couldn't freeze Mercury.
Guys, let it go. Nobody's gonna win this one.
Well, I've never cooked a turkey before, but the recipe's here. I guess I can fumble my way through. How far along are you?
I'm nearly done defrosting.
And the turkey?
Might I suggest you stuff it?
Where do you keep your saffron?
Third cupboard.
Mm-hmm. And where do you keep your shallots?
In the crisper. By the way, you still have to remove the entrails from the chest cavity.
In that case, where do you keep your 10-foot pole?
Half as excited as he's going to be when he sees these new videotapes. 12 cassettes of the history of World War II.
For those who thought the original was fun but too short.
Well, this year I thought, what the hell? You know, give him something he really wants instead of what I think he needs.
That's a very commendable sentiment.
What did you get him?
An Armani tux.
Clamour, boy, she's back.
You know, I keep meaning to ask, what's that lovely perfume you're wearing?
Yes, I've been wondering that myself.
It's called Milady's Boudoir. You wouldn't believe what a bargain it is. For $100, I could buy enough to drown myself in.
I've got 60.
Don't you look handsome in your best bib and tucker. Come on and give Aunt Sherry a great big kiss. Or
perhaps just a friendly wave from across the room.
Oh, I haven't seen any decent Oriental knockers since Empress Chow's Shanghai Review.
She's as funny as she is classy.
No argument there.
Goodbye, Niles. Don't worry, I'm not gonna kiss you. I know it embarrasses you. Wait, come here. You got some schmutz on your cheek. My mistake, it's a mole. You might want to have that checked.
Oh, I think now I'll just play it safe and have it removed. Last night I invited Dad to use my apartment for a quiet romantic dinner with Sherry while I attended La Traviata. Mm. Well, production was just dreadful.
Oh, oh.
In A Forse Lui, soprano couldn't hit the E-flat above high C to save her life. So I got so fed up, I stormed out, drove home, entered my apartment, and when I saw what Dad and Sherry were doing there, I hit the note myself.
You mean they were...
They were.
Oh. What did you do?
Pulled up a chaise lounge and took out my opera glasses. What do you think I did?
Who's on that table?
Roz, Niles was here first.
No, but I'm meeting someone. Please, guys.
Oh, who is it? Another one of your till dawn do us part relationships?
Niles, why would you even want to live in such a stodgy building? You know, when I applied there, they treated me like I was riffraff.
Well, if you're going to ask and answer your own questions, what do you need me for?
Was there no other service you could have performed?
The only other option was visiting old people in a retirement home.
And you chose this?
Well, think about it. Walking the streets picking up trash, you can see how Roz would go with the familiar.
Niles.
Oh, Frederick, my. Aren't you getting big?
I'm the same exact size I was the last time you saw me.
Well, your mother's cooking will do that for a growing boy.
I don't know how many more of your disastrous love stories I can hear. I'll say when.
Hello.
You look like an almost presentable version of someone who works with my brother.
Bite me.
Oh, it is you.
See, she's a rather famous supermodel, and right now she's going through a breakup with a star football player on the Seahawks. And she didn't want any publicity. So, you see, before I identify her to you, I have to ask that you not ever repeat this to anyone.
I'd urge you to do the same.
Crime to go down to Acapulco and come back empty-handed?
I did not come back empty-handed. I came back with two huge handfuls. Listen, Kelly was just here. She was called away on an emergency.
That would be a modeling emergency?
Hey, get a load of that schnozzolo. No, wait. Guess who I am?
I give up.
I'm Waldo. From Where's Waldo? You know, the guy you can't find because he blends into the crowd.
I don't know, but I'd love a demonstration.
Actually, he took it very well. He's not going to be that involved, though. He moved to Cairo.
Where would he have moved to if he'd taken it badly?
Niles, please, would you excuse us?
Oh, by all means, I just came in to open a bottle of wine. Sorry.
Niles, do you mind? It's impossible to have a private conversation with you constantly eavesdropping.
I don't know what you two are talking about, but I resent the implication that I have nothing better to do than spy on you like a nosy teenager. I came in for a corkscrew.
Oh, Niles, I'm sorry.
All I could get was she hasn't told the father.
I love your show.
Oh, thank you.
I just think you're like the smartest guy on the face of the earth.
Well, one does hear tales of a certain wise man in Tibet, but why split hairs? There you are.
Thanks.
Thank you. Where was I?
Oh, you were last seen hiking up Mount Ego. Happy Fraser Crane Day. Or is it Merry Fraser Crane Day? I can never remember.
Very amusing.
I'll have a half-calf cappuccino. Sorry I'm late. I stopped halfway to listen to a jolly band of Fraser Crane Day carolers.
I tried to join in on the 12 days of Frasier, but forgot the words around day 7. How does it go again?
I believe it's 7 snobs of sniping.
I'm feeling a tad sluggish.
Oh, up late last night?
Well, I'm afraid so. As usual, I left it at the last minute to write all my Frasier Crane Day cards.
Funny thing happened at the lodge last night. Jack Nicholson and Tom Brokaw discovered they were wearing exactly the same jacket, so they staged a mock fight. Suddenly, Donna Karen flew between them, pretending to referee. I laughed so hard I nearly spilled my toddy on someone named Puff Daddy.
Can I get anything else for you here?
Just a dustpan and broom to sweep up some of these names.
Well, I'm afraid I have to cancel. It's my 1 month anniversary with Sam. I'd like to take her to L'Escalier for dinner.
I understand, of course. 1 month is quite a milestone. Thanks for the reminder. I need to change my water filter.
Listen and tell me if you think I sound desperate.
Hi, Sam. Two quick things. Dinner at L'Escalier is now at 8:30, and the judge needs to see you at 9 tomorrow morning, not 10. Bye.
I didn't get desperate. I got feminine.
Shut up, Niles.
Hello, Sam. It's Frasier. Give me a call if you get a chance. Bye.
You don't sound desperate at all.
Hi, Sam. I forgot to mention I'll be at the office. Call me. It's Frasier.
Well, maybe just a whiff of desperation.
Hi, I'm at the office now. Still at the office. I stepped out to the coffee machine, thought I might have missed you.
How quickly a whiff becomes a stench. But you could see yourself falling in love with her.
Possibly.
Sometime down the line.
Yes, yes, perhaps.
Well, no wonder you're heartbroken. You've just lost the only woman you could even possibly, sometime down the line, perhaps, fall in love with. I'm surprised the country music people haven't jumped all over this world.
Things never did seem quite right between us. God, if it hadn't been for her friends, I probably would have broken it off myself. Oh, God. Shame on me.
Don't punish yourself, Frasier. At least you're deep enough to realize you're shallow.
Yes.
So let's just see what we have to work on. Why don't you start here, O Knight? And okay. I want to hear you really attack the note.
Okay. O Knight, when Christ was born, O Knight, divine!
Sometimes the note sees the attack coming and retreats.
Frasier.
Well, that bun looks good.
Now, remember your diet.
Speaking of buns, I could do without. Lilith is back.
Oh, that explains why blood was pouring from all my faucets this morning.
Distant cousin has a slight crush on Niles.
A slight crush. There are cannibals who are less man-hungry. I've never missed the Kennel Club show. If I don't go this year, people will think I've let Maris and Shankman intimidate me. I want to prove that I'm strong and independent, and I can't do that alone.
Well,
thank you. I knew I could count on you for this, Frasier. It's nice to know some things never change.
Do you guys know where I can get a cheap hotel room in a hurry?
Case in point. Goodbye, Rosalind.
But it's just that my car battery went dead at a light, and I didn't have my cell phone with me. By the time I got a jump, I realized that I couldn't go directly to the restaurant because I was wearing these ridiculous shorts, and I know how this sounds, but it's the truth here. Just ask my brother.
They're ridiculous shorts.
Tell you one thing, I don't envy Kenny. Feeling the cold stares of the other employees? Because he's fired the station's most popular personality?
He fired Tootie the Story Lady, too?
Very funny, Niles.